It's unlocked. Your sister and her husband stopped by. I let them in as usual.
Oh, is that all? Thank you.
I wish that were all.
Mrs. Adams, you'll have to give me one more day.
I'd love to give you all the time you need. But Jones and Company had me on the carpet again this morning. If you could see your way clear to letting me have just 1 month...
Don't they know who I am? Didn't you tell them that there's a contract on my agent's desk right now with just a few minor details to iron out?
I told them. But they're an impersonal organization. You're not Miss Elliot to them. You're merely the tenant of... Number 1257. But sometimes families are different. Couldn't you perhaps ask your relatives?
My goodness, Margaret, where you been? Roy and I got to get started for Alhambra.
Well, I didn't know you were coming, Faith.
It's the first of the month.
Miss Elliot, don't let it worry you tonight. We'll talk tomorrow.
You been to some glamour party?
Yeah, I had a ball.
Oh, no, Margaret. I'm hungry.
Right. Well, my goodness, you seem to have plenty of time to do everything except get out to Alhambra. Mama's been asking after you. Her hip still hasn't mended. She's in bed most of the day. Of course, I'm not complaining, but, well, with the twins on my hands... Aw, you ought to see those twins, Margaret. Such great big boys. Growing out of everything. I haven't bought a stitch for myself lately. Not a stitch. Well, the cost of shoes alone for those boys...
I'm afraid I haven't any shoes for 14-year-old boys.
For heaven's sakes, who was asking? I was just telling you the family news. Aren't you interested?
I have some rather interesting family news, too. I've just come from my auction.
You mean you're selling all those nice things?
I'm not. My creditors are. I'm bankrupt. Broke. Get it?
Understand? Well. Well, my goodness, I always knew you were extravagant at all. Whoever needed two Cadillacs? And all those servants and secretaries and always redecorating the house and such. But I never said anything because you would have gotten mad if I did. You were making all that money. I still don't see where it all went.
I'll explain it to you. I bought the house you're living in. You promised to pay me back, remember? And I paid for the birth of the twins, their clothes, their saxophone lessons, and Roy's four operations.
Can I help it if Roy enjoys poor health?
And you know what Mother cost me?
Mama is living with us now.
And I set Roy up in business after he'd been fired from the job I got him. In the purchasing department at the studio.
But it was your idea that he should have an antique shop. Roy didn't know anything about antiques, did you, Roy?
And he didn't know anything about the laundry business either. That was his idea.
Was it his fault everybody started buying whirlpools?
No, no, girls, let's not have a ruckus. If you'll just give us the monthly check, Margaret, we'll be shoving along.
Can't you get it through your thick skull that I'm broke? Dead, flat, stony, broke. See? I've got $3.85 in my purse. Do you want that, Roy?
Margaret didn't mean that, Faith.
I have given you over $50,000. You must have some of it stashed away. Could I have $200 on account tonight, Roy?
What?
Margaret, for heaven's sakes, where would we get money like that?
Well, you could print it if I'd only thought to give Roy a printing press.
Oh, you're tired. You wouldn't say things like that unless...
Yes, I'm sick and I'm tired. Now, leave me alone. Leave me alone!
Well, if that's the way you feel...
That is the way I feel about it. Now, I want you both to get out of here. Get out! Let you and me get...